The Final Cut Pro 11 update came with quite a few amazing new features everyone's talking about, like the magnetic mask, auto captions, and a few more. But that's not it. It also came with a bunch of smaller, quality of life improvements that aren't getting nearly as much attention. I'll cover the bigger features in the near future, but in this video, I want to focus on the smaller things not many people are talking about. The first new feature I want to talk about today is a new built-in share destination. Final Cut Pro now lets you export your files directly to your Photos app. I actually had to dig around quite a bit to find this one. To add it, press Command comma to open your preferences window and select the Destinations tab. Click Add Destination, and first thing you'll notice here is the export file preset now has a share icon on it. Grab this preset and drag it over to your destination sidebar. To make this easier to find, let's rename it and call it Photos. Now, in this case, we probably don't need super high quality. So what I would recommend here is changing the format to computer, H.264 or HEVC for a codec, and I normally set the video resolution to the highest available option. This is the max resolution, so if you're exporting an HD clip, it won't upscale it, but at least it won't drop the resolution of your videos. Next, open the Action drop-down menu and select Add to Photos. Close your Preferences window. Now, when you want to export your project, click the Share button and select your Photos destination. Normally, after you hit the Share button, you get another window where you choose where your saved file is going. In this case, since Final Cut Pro already knows where your export is going, you won't get it. Click Share, and after your export is complete, you'll find your export in the Photos app. I actually use this feature quite a bit more than I thought I would. My most common use is when I'm editing a project, especially for family videos, and there's a clip I really like. I can just select the Arrange tool, click and drag out Arrange in my timeline, and export it to my Photos app. Selecting Arrange in my timeline only exports the part I selected, and since my photos sync across all my devices, my highlight is instantly available on all of them. This is also handy if you edit for social media where the files have to be uploaded from your phone. Another feature added to Final Cut Pro 11 that seems minor but is actually really useful is the ability to hide clips. This is a great way to declutter your media browser. To hide a clip, right-click on it and select Hide Clip. This completely removes all traces of it from your media browser, but it doesn't delete it. To see your hidden clips, click the Clip Appearance icon in the top right of your media browser and select the Show Hidden Clips checkbox. A perfect use for this is for multicam clips. If you combine two or more clips into a multicam clip, you can hide the originals because all of them live in the new multicam clip you just made. To take this one step further, Final Cut Pro automatically does this for you. When you select multiple clips and combine them into a single multicam clip, you now get an option to hide original clips. With this box selected, as soon as you make a multicam clip, the original clips are automatically gone. Same goes for synchronized clips. When I film these videos, I always record my audio separately. Then I import both into Final Cut Pro and synchronize them to replace my camera audio with the higher quality audio. What I was doing before was rejecting the original clips, then using the Hide Rejected view. I want these original clips out of my browser so I don't accidentally use one. This new feature saves me a bunch of steps. Now I can just sync my clips and make sure the Hide Original Clips checkbox is selected. The originals are gone, and I have my new clip replacing them. If you ever do need the originals, either from a multicam clip or a synchronized clip, you can find them with the rest of your hidden clips. Number three on my list is keyboard shortcuts. I love keyboard shortcuts. Learning and using them has saved me so much time in Final Cut Pro, and now with the latest update, we get a bunch more. If you need to rename a clip in your timeline, instead of trying to find that clip in the media browser and renaming it there, you can now just hit Ctrl+Command+R and rename your clip right in the timeline. When working on your audio mix, Ctrl+Option+Command+S will show or hide your audio lanes, making it much easier to batch adjust volumes based on roles. If you navigate your timeline with the JKL keys, you can now slow down your playback. Option+L will play your timeline at half speed. Option+J will play backwards at half speed. If you use Apple Motion, Shift+Option+Command+C will consolidate all your motion content into your library. Shift+Option+Command+V will paste timecode, and my favorite, Shift+Command+H will toggle on and off the show horizon overlay. Number four is the reframe effect. Now, this feature has been talked about, but not enough. First here is the picture-in-picture effect. I love how simple and intuitive it is. To use it, just layer your clips and add this effect to your top clip. Use the blue handles in the corners to adjust the size of your picture-in-picture window. Once you're happy with the size, use the on-screen controls to scale and frame the clip inside this window. To reposition it, simply click anywhere inside this window and drag. In the inspector, you can round the corners with a roundness slider and add an outline with the outline slider. I love the way these animate in and out too. You can animate this window in from a full screen image or come in from any direction. Same for the out animation. The second effect in this category is the callout effect, and it's perfect for highlighting specific parts in your clip. I see myself using this one all the time. The controls are very similar to the picture-in-picture effect. You add it to your clip and use the on-screen controls to adjust the framing. And look at how seamless the in and out animations are. Love it. Next up is timeline navigation. If you ever need to move a clip up or down a layer in your timeline, sometimes that can be a real pain in the ass, especially if you have lots of layers. This is much easier in Final Cut Pro 11. To move up a layer, just select your clip and press Option Up arrow. To move down, Option Down arrow. So much easier. Another feature I use all the time in Final Cut Pro is Zoom to Fit. Pressing Shift Z changes your timeline view so that your project fills a visible area in your timeline. Basically, it shrinks or expands your timeline to fit your entire project in the timeline window. But it only used to do it horizontally. For timelines with lots of layers, before Final Cut Pro 11, you still had to manually adjust your clip height or clip appearance to see all your clips. The new update brings another keyboard shortcut. Option Shift Z zooms to fit your timeline vertically. This automatically adjusts the height of your clips so all layers are visible. And last, but definitely not least, is you can now edit your projects at higher frame rates. Final Cut Pro 11 now supports timelines at 90, 100, and 120 frames per second. To set up a project with one of these new frame rates, press Command N to make a new project, and set the video format to custom. Type in your project resolution, and now, when you open the frame rate drop-down menu, you'll be able to select one of the new frame rates. Keep in mind though, these are only available in the custom video format. Selecting any of the other presets still limits your frame rate at 60. The more I play around with this new version of Final Cut Pro, the more cool new features I discover. It just gets better and better. I've had a few people tell me in the comments this should have been version 10.9. I respectfully disagree. Between the big new features and all the small things added, I feel Apple made the right move by calling it Final Cut Pro 11, and I can't wait to see what else we get in the future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.